This kind of music evokes a lot of emotion for a lot of people, but I'm assuming without the music, the facts and figures and the knowledge sometimes that you get, either new information or something that you're studying, gives you that same kind of emotion in dealing with these big ideas.
So let me agree and disagree. So the part where I agree is that, yeah, when you study the universe or any frontier where no one has stepped before, there's a certain thrill, an exhilaration, an uplifting mood that I was going to say was indescribable, but I'm going to try to describe it. It's as though you laid eyes upon something that no one has seen before, and now it's your task to communicate this fact. The beauty, the splendor, the majesty, the wonder, all of this combined. That is what goes on the frontier of scientific discovery. I think it also goes on the frontier of artistic expression. But here's the difference. I can discover something in the universe, but if I didn't do it, somebody else after me will discover that exact same thing. Whereas in the arts, what you create, no one who was ever born before you or will be born from your death onwards will ever compose exactly the same thing you did. So in that sense, art is a unique expression of the individual, whereas the science is the discovery of the pre-existing conditions of nature. And so each requires certain levels of creativity to make those discoveries, to engage the frontier in ways no one has engaged it before. But at the end of the day, consider that, you know, the expression, oh, he's got it down to a science. Well, the other side of that is that he's raised it to an art. Right? Those are two sides of the same coin. And those capture the difference and the commonality between the two.